Hi, Ernest Lee here. Thousand Mile March for Liberty, Ernest. The 25 Months for Liberty Countdown, Ernest. The Grassroots Ambassador for the Convention of States Project, Ernest. And right now my proudest moment is as General Lee of the RideForTheConstitution.org. I got off in a quiet corner here. History was made today. The mainstream media was offering no coverage of it. As a matter of fact, I imagine they'll spin it and downplay it. And y'all are hungry for the results of the truckers in D.C. We split our trucks that have been growing in number each and every day. And let me tell you something. Everybody's been asking number. How many were there? Well, I want to tell you, the answer to that question is more than enough. Been a lot of video shot, a lot of footage. I wanted to do this quiet and talk to you and tell you how things went today from my perspective. We sent a platoon, we'll say, of bobtail trucks right to the World War II Memorial. Pete Santilli, Guerrilla Media Network, live feeds on RideForTheConstitution.org. Pete had microphones on the ground at the War Memorial, video photographers on the ground. Mainstream media had coverage there as well. But while these events were going on, while they were taking place, I know for a fact, Guerrilla Media was doing live streams. When the people saw those bobtail trucks, and the bobtail trucks laid on their air horns, they were mobbed by supporters. Cheers went out through the thousands and thousands of patriotic Americans gathered there. While this was taking place, we didn't want to distract or take away from the veterans. They made one pass through there to show that we, the truckers, were behind them. Then the main convoy force, full trailered with an escort of over 200 four-wheeled vehicles, everybody with flags flying, everybody with the support, everybody flying the hashtags or having the hashtag T4Vets. They also had hashtag T2SDA for truckers to shut down America. They supported us every step along the way. As the crowd at the World War II Memorial began to disperse, they dismantled the barricades around that monument, marching en masse down Pennsylvania Avenue, carrying pieces of the barricade to lay at Barry's front door, his temporary residence. Mr. Obama with a small O. I have no respect for this man. He needs to resign. He needs to be impeached. He's guilty of treason and reigning tyranny down upon the people of America. While they were in the midst of their march, our main caravan of trucks completely shut off all access in to D.C. We choked them off across all lanes, moving at speeds of only 5 and 10 miles an hour for the next mile and a half, laying on our air horns, the people marching from the memorial to the White House heard the trucks having their back, having access to downtown Washington, D.C. completely shut off, backing up cars for over 10 miles behind us, all the horns going. And you know, the people behind us, they weren't angry. They weren't angry. As we then opened a lane for them to pass, as we turned to go northeast out of Washington, D.C., as they came by us, they were giving us the thumbs up out the window, pumping their arms for us to hit the horns some more. But the people doing the march heard the truckers. They went crazy, chanting, "Go truckers, go truckers." I had the privilege of participating and being able to listen live thanks to Pete Santilli, a great American patriot. So, has the movement actually started? T today, 10/13/13, should go down in history as the springboard date that we the people were waking up, woke up. The administration, the government, the status quo, they are scared to death. They had the traffic cameras blanked out. They had their media on a string, refusing to cover any of this live. We the people will be getting the real story out. This is Ernest Lee on 10/13/13. Thank you for your support. God bless America.